Hi guys, welcome back. In this video, I'll be building a custom Ubuntu appliance image using the Ubuntu appliance snap package. You could think of building a custom Ubuntu image if maybe you're porting Ubuntu core to an unsupported board, device, or you're building one with pre-installed snap. In this video, after building my own custom Ubuntu appliance image, I'll be testing it on a Raspberry Pi 3. So now let's go through the building process. First, I'll have to ensure that the basic snap packages that I will need to build this Ubuntu appliance image are installed in my laptop. To ensure that Snapcraft is installed on your laptop, you can use the same command like that of installing it, which is snap install classic Snapcraft. There you go, you can see it's already installed, right? Okay, so the next package to ensure that it's also installed is Ubuntu image. For you to also, the command to install it is snap install classic Ubuntu image, which also show that it's already installed in my machine. There you go. And the last one is RNG tools. So install using sudo apt install rng tools. Let's enter my password. Okay, we are good to go. So here we'll be going through the build process. I have to check if I have Signin keys already installed or I want to create a new one. So now for me to check the ones that I already have installed, I'll use the command snapcraft list keys. There you go. These are the ones I've installed in the past and I've used it in one or two projects. But for the benefit of newcomers, I will be installing it again so you can know how to go about it when you're installing a new Signin key. So I will use the command snapcraft create key. Then the key name. For this one, I will use my key. That's my key name. Yeah, just press enter. Give your Signin key a password to encrypt it. Yeah, that's it. Confirm password. Good to go. Voila, key has been created. So now I have to register the key I just created using the command snapcraft register key. Since I have many of them, I'll add the key name behind it. Register key, my key. That's the key I want to register. This is the email address I use to create my Ubuntu One account. If you don't have one, check our previous videos on how to create one. So that's mine. Enter it. Password I used to create the account to. Okay, remember the password we used to encrypt our Signin key. We have to enter it here again. That's it. Good to go. Okay, so the next thing is, below the video you will see a link to a blog post, which you click and just copy the code on the blog post. From there, I will continue to guide you on how to move forward, how to edit it. So this is the code, copy it, paste it in any editor of your choice. I'll be using VS Code. Yeah. Okay, so now we'll be replacing all the content, all the records that have these arrow keys. Yeah, with their real values. That's it. Four items to be replaced, and this is the last one. Timestamp. So for the first one, your account ID. Remember, I said you need your Ubuntu One account. So you just go back to the blog post, click on this link. It takes you to your Ubuntu One account details, where you'll be able to copy your account ID. So here, this is my own Snap account ID. Just need to copy it. Yeah. And I paste it as authority ID. That's it. Same thing as brand ID. So I also paste it there. Okay. Model. My model name, I can name it anything I like, anything you can imagine. Even if it's my house, my Ubuntu appliance, or whatever, anything. So for this case, I'll name it my Ubuntu Customize. And the timestamp. For you to have your current timestamp, you have to run the command, this command on the command line. Okay. Date. Dash I second dash UTC. There you go. So now I'll copy this timestamp and I'll paste it on VS Code. To go. So lastly, I have to save this file anywhere accessible. I prefer the desktop, and I will save it as a JSON file. So I'll choose desktop. Py3 and name it Py3 model. JSON. Desktop. Okay, good to go. So the next thing is to concatenate the content of a JSON file and the key we just created. So I'm using the command cat pymodel.json. Yeah, snap sign key. My key. So I'll be naming the file that will contain these two. Py3.model. Okay. Oh, what happened? Error. Oh, the first error is no source file or directory. Remember, I saved this file on the desktop, right? So I have to CD to my desktop first before I run this command. That's it. Okay. Oh, we have an error. Oh, there's an error in the code. Look at, I didn't remove this last arrow sign. So I have to go and edit it again. Uh-oh, didn't notice. That's it. Save. Ensure everything is good. So gonna run the command again. See, everything is okay. So now I'll be building our Ubuntu appliance image using the command sudo ubuntu. You remember the snap package we need to build this image is Ubuntu image. So we'll be using the command sudo ubuntu image dash o py image. Py image is the direction where the image we're building will be saved. Py3.model. It will take some time while the all that needs to be set up is being downloaded and set up, so we just have to be patient for some time. Okay, so as you can see, we are done building our Ubuntu appliance image. Everything is set up. So if we go now to the directory we save the py3 image, this is it. You'll see our image is at py.image, that is it. Yeah, so now since I've connected my SD card onto this machine, I'll use extra to flash my SD card. So flash from file. I choose the file desktop py3 image. That's it. It's already been selected. That's my SD card. Flash. Put my password. That's it. It will go for a couple of minutes, 1 or 2 minutes, and we'll be good to go. So I can now use it, insert it on my Raspberry Pi 3 and continue the configurations. After I flashed the Ubuntu appliance image I built on the SD card, I've inserted it on the Raspberry Pi 3, which now needs to be configured. So the first thing, I'll press enter to continue the configuration. That's it. Set up a wireless network. Configure Wi-Fi setting. I have to scan for networks available. So that's the one we want to connect to. Okay, that's what I want to connect to. So now I have to input the password. So I will use the option DHCP4. And there we are done. I have to put in the email address I have associated with my Ubuntu One account. That's it. My Ubuntu is set up. So I can now insert into my Ubuntu through my laptop using the IP address stated there. So now let's see how it looks like on the laptop. Now that I'm done configuring this the Ubuntu appliance Ubuntu configurations to set up my machine, everything is set and I can now SSH into my machine with the IP address that is showing on the monitor connected to the Raspberry Pi. So here I'll have to SSH into it using SSH my username, IP address, there you go. I already have access into my Ubuntu appliance.
So now I can install any snap package I want. I play around and with the different features, everything is good. So that's it. This is my customized Ubuntu Appliance Image I've installed on Raspberry Pi 3. Thank you and see you in the next video.